Welcome to the World's Fair Hotel.
Stop talking so slow.
Mr.
Holmes. Henry Howard Holmes. I'm not finished yet.
Jeff, you better come help.
I said get...
If not like this.
So, what do you think?
They don't like it.
What can I do for you? Just to do that.
Actually, it's what I can do for you. Hear me out.
Before we go any further, I have to ask that we lock up your phones for safekeeping.
No. But like, blurry figures. Build a relationship. In case someone dies, it's gonna hurt more. He had to bring other people so that he could leave, maybe. Someone could see through that. That's two-sided. Taxidermy. Is he gonna taxidermy them?
Well,
I'm looking.
Is that how you say that?
Oh.
Like it's a verb?
Kate wanted you to have this.
Breaking down walls, navigating the maze of anxiety. Are you kidding me?
I think she thought it might help with your stress, or...
Absolutely not. I'm not stressed.
Oh.
Okay?
Why are you throwing things down hallway?
Stressed.
Yes.
That was rhetorical.
Well, your cards came out nice enough.
Oh, yeah. Embossing makes a huge difference.
I don't like
him. The old guys love business cards. Old school. You old school guys.
I also put it on heavy stock and did the logo in foil.
Ooh. Great.
I should have had one ready for Mr. Dumet. Did you find them?
No. I swear I put them in here. I don't understand.
Why isn't he packing his own bag? I want everybody to start being
nice. Stop tearing around in there like a maniac. Be organized about it. Methodical.
Blue bag, front pocket. I made a specific mental note of it.
Why doesn't he needs to pack his stuff?
Gone? Just like that? Are you saying somebody took them?
I don't...
Actually, I can see Kate doing that. Or Jamie.
I'm sorry.
He's going down a path. You know what?
It's fine. No. Let's just get on with things.
I almost made him bad. I'm going to make everybody good.
This place is massive. Surely there is a pack of cigarettes in here somewhere. Even if they're ancient.
You need them that bad?
There was a bar off the lobby. There must be cigarettes in the bar, right?
I mean, technically, it's not legal to smoke in bars, so...
Come on, we're checking. If you find them first, all will be forgiven.
What needs to be forgiven? Because you didn't pack your own bag? Also, he's acting like this is... It's a cigarette. You'll be fine.
It's my spare cap.
Exactly the same?
Well, it suits me. What's weird about that?
That's weird. That's strange. Okay. Oop, what's that? Yellow cross, T.S. Hartley. Okay. Best-selling author Shroud of Innocence comes a thrilling and reimagining of one of history's most merciless massacres. Kill them all, God will recognize his own. Jeez. July 22nd, 1209, in just one day, the peaceful city of Braziers has been plunged into massacre. Tyrant crusader Simon de Montfort is determined to purge the city of all practicing Cathars by the most horrific means necessary. I can't read today. Deep in the church of St. Mary Magdalene's hidden caverns, a last remaining group of Cathar perfecti have hidden away, but can't hide forever. The youngest perfecti, Father Escrivan, has come up with a desperate plan to escape with the help of his lifelong friend, Catholic priest Murray. But it all hinges on the fine balance of bravery and faith, gripping, thrilling history come alive. This is Hartley at its finest. Hopefully, I'm reading things because I'm hoping that they come in handy at some point, which, who knows. all be forgiven. Didn't they say we had 10 minutes until we were going to talk?
This place.
And he's fiending for a cigarette?
Are you worried it will make our other episodes look cheap?
They are cheap. Can't be helped. This
just keep the book.
Will be the one that people remember.
Keep the book.
The one that wins an Emmy?
Exactly. That's the spirit.
20 years
Stick
experience.
With me, Erin. I'm going places.
A step-by-step guide designed to give you the tools you need to path.
Let me worry about that. You stick to making sure that my life runs smoothly, and I'll make sure you keep working. Sound good?
Sure.
So she's personal assistant and audio tech? Okay. Let's see. I went to the dentist today. I got a crown. Left side of my mouth is starting to get feeling again. I haven't eaten yet. I did get some donuts for the house, so I should go get one. I will in a bit. Hold on. It's just an end of a hallway. Breathing all hard. You should really quit smoking cigarettes. Is it the 80s? Why are you smoking cigarettes? Ooh, okay. Oh no. Good evening, thank you for allowing me to contact you directly. Your publisher said that you were very keen to hear from me. It seems we have mutual interest. I spent several years constructing the ultimate homes tourist experience by faithfully recreating the World's Fair Hotel. We have not yet opened to the public as there are finishing touches to complete, and I consider a man of your knowledge could provide insight that is invaluable before our official opening. Therefore, I invite you to visit the hotel for a weekend. The experience is designed to accommodate groups of 5 guests, so I extend the invitation to 4 friends or family of your choosing. I must insist that this invitation be kept confidential until the hotel is publicly announced, so please only invite guests that you can trust to do so. I hope you can accept my invitation. Please reply to confirm your attendance, and the 4 additional guests you would like to bring. Should you accept, a limousine will pick you up and your guests at 7 p.m. this Friday underneath the railway bridge at corner of S. Wallace Avenue and 63rd in Inglewood, Chicago. I'm sure you'll find the experience very interesting indeed. Then you say, hey, we're not the first group of people to come out here. Speak on it. Say something. Nothing? What's the date on that? The date is October 14th. Do we know? Will it tell us what day it is if I do the deal? Stiletto shoe, missing a heel. Ah, there's a heel, that's why they're connected. Okay, bearings. Jeff was killed in the gas room and Mary bled to death. It's gonna come in handy later. Jeff ran from Holmes leaving Marie. Marie didn't have anything heavy enough to hit Holmes with. So if she had something heavy enough to hit him with, she could have hit him. We just investigate the noise. Do you favor the necklace purchased from the jewelry counter? She purchased the tent. Yeah, I should have got something heavy. Okay. So what's this? The crew met him. Hold on. Received a call from him, accepted an invitation to the house. They met him. Kate saw a girl in the window. Okay. Invited her to the room. Dropped her chapstick. They kissed. Okay. Bitter rivals. Jamie teased Kate about her fame when talking about the girl they saw. Okay. She doesn't like her at all. Erin struggled to breathe after inhaling dust. She used her inhaler, okay? But no date. Charlie and Jamie. So him and Mark have the best relationship so far. Okay. I need him to say something about that email.
Hey, Charlie. I was hoping next season maybe I could do more with the sound design, more creative stuff.
Erin, what you already do for this company is very valuable to us.
Carrying your bags and picking up your laundry?
Oh, she's just straight up assistant.
To get ahead in this industry, you have to pay your dues. Show you're ready to muck in.
I think you should get an assistant.
Yeah.
An assistant?
Yeah, she just not.
A stupid idea, Charlie. I'm
an
just.
An assistant.
Yeah.
A personal assistant.
Yeah.
Sort of. And then I could help out with the editing.
Pardon me? The editing?
The audio mix. Look, I just think you've got so much to give, so much experience.
Mm-hmm.
And it's an opportunity to pass that knowledge on.
Right. Yes, I suppose it is.
Oh.
And an assistant wouldn't lose my cigarettes, would they?
No, because they're paid to not lose them.
So, do you still want to direct movies, Charlie?
I am directing.
I don't want to mess up this dialogue.
No, but I mean real movies. With a big budget and big stars.
Erin, there's something important that you have to understand. In the work that we do, the very important work, the truth is the star.
Oh, right. Yeah, sorry, Charlie. So you don't want to direct
movies? Yeah.
Can we move
yes
on
or no?
from this?
Just say no. Just say no. I'm not good enough. I don't believe in myself enough. I'm too stressed out. I smoke too many cigarettes. I got a lot of problems. I got a lot of things going on. Okay, let me go check this email just because I need to know. Like Mark Antony. To Joseph Morello, October 14th, Joseph Morello. Excuse me, ma'am. Okay. Just his breathing. Next page should be, yep, Joseph Morello, or the whole Morello family, and then us. So he brought his whole family. So it's either Michelle or Natalie or Bethany. It's a little girl. Do you think, no. Because maybe that was Dumas' little girl. I don't know. Okay. We're still looking for
I suppose I should be
cigarettes.
It's just my cigarettes that are missing and not our gear.
Well, they went through everything. Clearly. Nothing. Okay. Let's see.
Hey, maybe Mr. Dumet is in the back office. You
maybe.
Could just ask him about cigarettes.
No, he left. He left, and Homegirl didn't say anything to you. I'm telling my friends everything I see. Doors with keyholes can be unlocked using keys. Open the bar. I don't have a key. Okay. Back to the front. Hey,
jackpot.
Okay.
Erin.
Nice.
I found the key.
Here we go. Now we cooking. Here we go. He's really got to get his breathing under control. We need to maybe take him on a run.
Why don't I go check for a gift shop or something? I've already had one asthma attack today, and this dust farm is exactly what I don't need.
A gift shop might have cigarettes.
Exactly.
Atta girl.
No, why are you splitting up? I don't understand. Show me something. Show me a vision. It's of him getting burned alive. We just saw him. Him. He is. Charlie. We saw Charlie getting burned alive. And I think he's looking at a picture of the skin. Hair growing out of it. See that epidermis? What's the Simpsons episode? Your epidermis is showing! And he falls and breaks his arm. Or his leg. His leg. And then Bart is sitting in his window, hating on everybody that gets to swim.
Hello?
Great episode. Hi.
Wow.
Oh.
An animatronic. Ha!
That's
what
amazing.
Will it be, Mr. Demetz, sir?
I'll have a packet of cigarettes, please. A packet of cigarettes, please. Hello? Hello? A packet of smokes. Figured it was too good to be true. Never mind. Thank you, Robo Bowman.
Certainly, sir. Whatever you wish.
No way.
One pack.
Thank you very much, my mechanical friend. Much appreciated.
Do you have money to use that vending machine, though? Well, hold on. Let's look at some things first, because I feel like something bad's gonna happen that I won't be able to be in here anymore. Yeah, move that. Move this. Once again, I'd like to... Miss Kelly Schroeder. November 2017, okay. Once again, I'd like to thank you for the incredible work you and your team achieved at the hotel. I'd like to extend my heartfelt condolences. The accident that befell the skeleton crew on the lake is nothing short of a tragedy, and I, in part, feel responsible. In honor of them, I've spent the last several months applying the finishing touches to the hotel, and I'm proud to say that we are almost ready to open for the public. Please allow me to extend my sincere gratitude. I invite yourself and the rest of your team to join me for the grand opening ceremony, 7 p.m. Friday, November 17th, at 2017. I promise a spectacular evening with themed entertainment, including a barbershop quartet. I'm sure you will agree that all your hard work was worth it when you enjoy the unique hotel experience. Richard Belknap. I don't think I like Richard Belknap. I'll get to the cigarettes. But first, check this room. I very much feel like once I interact with these cigarettes, I'm out of here. So, let's see.
Yes! Yes! Of course it wants exact change. Damn it!
Do not break that. You gonna steal money from the bar, dude? Gotta press the button. Press the change button. Ayy. There we go.
Next round's on me.
Come on.
Promise.
Ooh, hold on. Hold, please. Hold, please. Oh, it's just the light shining off. Okay. I thought I saw something shiny. Proximity mine style in GoldenEye. See the shiny thing? You gotta shoot it.
Jump to daddy.
I hope they don't come out. Because you shouldn't be smoking them anyway.
Oi! Oh, no, 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 please, come on, no!
Maybe if I didn't hit it, then it would have dropped.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord.
Something horrible's happening. That's it. Nope. Nope.
What? No, come on, you piece of... Don't do this to me!
Come on. Get ready for something. Don't!
Antique rubbish. Give them to me! Give me my cigarettes!
A child.
Right, you. That's it. I'm gonna go and get my key grip, and they are gonna kick the out of you.
Hey, Charlie.
Yeah, I'm still in the bar.
I think it's dinner time. We should get everyone else.
Okay, I'm coming. And I'm coming back for you with a pry bar.
What
are
happened
you alone
to,
in there?
In 10 minutes.
Who's that behind
let's
the bar?
Talk.
What?
You gonna answer her? No? All right, cool. There's a lot happening in this. Okay, Mark, let's go, Mark.
Hey, had a thought on an intro segment.
You want to shoot now?
Yeah, if we get it shot and in the bank, maybe Charlie will stop rewriting everything I come up with.
Got him.
Yeah. Okay, sure.
What?
Nothing. Just give me a sec and I'll be good to go.
I'm supposed to buy nothing is eating away at you?
Yes.
What do you think?
How many times have you cleaned that lens?
I'm just prepping my gear.
Really?
Yeah.
Always focusing on the detail, Mark. What about taking a huge risk and just do something? I watched you fuss for a whole week before you turned down that job offer, all because you had to take one extra train to get there.
What's joke?
I turned down that job because that would have left you alone with Charlie. How cruel do you think I am?
I'm being serious.
So am I.
Fine. I'll drop it.
Great. Let me grab the camera.
Let's use natural light so we can do it alone.
Didn't the lobby have skylight?
I don't remember. I just want to look decent.
Uh-oh. With my heart.
You look good in any light.
I like that you answer with your heart or your brain.
Trying to butter me up.
Yes. Is it working?
Yes, I am.
Marginally.
There we go. Come on, boo up. Boo up so these deaths are real sad.
Why are you letting the mole think I broke up with you? I feel like if Jamie knew the truth, she might back off.
I mean, they all just assumed.
I can't decide if that's sweet or selfish. Or both.
He broke up with her. Let me say something.
Before we... Look, can I say something?
We agreed that we're sticking to just the job.
Yeah, but just right. Clear the air.
Which is why you can't just roll up and drive by psychoanalyze me.
Okay. You're right. That wasn't fair. I'm sorry. We don't need to rehash stuff. Let's just work.
I'm just going back and forth. He's hurting
this
emotionally.
This is proving harder than I thought. I don't want to be the one to...
And I quote, to accept the reality that this did not and will not work. Sound familiar?
Just because I said it doesn't mean I want to accept it.
So try harder.
Dang, I thought if they talked about it, they'd get past it. But I didn't know it was him.
Get started.
I didn't know it was him.
Thanks
who did it.
Thanks for doing this.
You're only asking me because your arms are too short for a good selfie angle.
My arms are not short.
So he broke up with her.
Where to?
And let everybody believe that she broke up with him because they already don't like her.
How's the new place?
It'll do for now.
You like it?
It's just a place to keep my crash. Short-term lease, so I can take my time to find something I really like.
Have?
That's smart plan.
You said I needed to be out, so I got out.
I was complimenting you.
Just saying.
I was worried you'd be sleeping on the couch in the studio while you obsessed over finding the perfect place with the right wall color near the proper train station or bus stop or...
Maybe we should just add this topic to our discussion no-fly zone list.
Yeah, you're probably right.
I need them to get together so these deaths are
next weekend okay to come and get my stuff?
Whoa, there, bucko.
I was just checking for light.
Remember our talk about boundaries? I need my room to be my private, safe place.
Didn't you walk into my room?
Sometimes I'm glad we went to therapy. Other times... It makes for some weird ass rules.
Well, regardless, there's still some emotions left in there. So if somebody kicks the bucket, then we're gonna be all right. We're gonna get ourselves a tearjerker. What is going on in there?
Back here.
What? What? As we say, hey Kate, look at this. Are you serious right now? We're just not gonna. And also, why are there hallways with no premonition? lighthouse in the water. But that means that if Homeboy doesn't burn to death, but maybe that's before he burns to death. Hopefully he doesn't, though. But we all know what's going to happen. Okay.
So, if Dumet catches us in here, are we breaking one of his rules? That scared the fuck out of me.
Yeah. Yeah, me too.
Yeah, I feel like Dumet is the kind of dude who loses if you break his rules.
Oh, what was your first clue? When he took away our phones like we were kind of teenagers?
I got the red light over here. I don't know if that finds anything. Was he the devil? Serial killer stuff. Yes. Since first book in 02, Joseph Morello has been fascinated by investigating serial killers, and none have intrigued him other than H.H. Holmes. In his latest paperback, Morello examines more than 15 years of his own research and writing, separating fact from fiction to provide evidence about the truth behind the historic case of America's first serial killer. Was he the devil? A must for Morello fans, Real Killers Magazine. And it's like an analysis of your worst nightmares. Review monthly. All right, we got papers. Or a cut in the desk.
This takes me back.
What
I used
does?
To carve the hell out of my desk in middle school.
Oh. Rebel.
I feel like that's not a good carve, though. That's like an animal. Or an I'm dying carve. I don't understand. Why do people carve stuff into things? Like, you're carving things into a desk, or when people carve stuff into bathroom walls, what are you bringing into a bathroom stall that allows you to carve? You just have a knife on you? Give me that book. Extend that monopod. Yeah. Ooh. That was close. Birth, death, marriages. Mr. and Mrs. Robert Hall of Silver Spring announced the birth of their daughter, Marilyn, on June 10th at White Oak Hospital. Elaine and Stephen Wright of North Park announced the birth of their son, Maurice, on June 10th at White Oak Hospital. On behalf of their daughter, Lucinda, Monday, proud grandparents, George and Irene, Monday of Silver Spring, announced the birth of their grandson, Hector Whalen, on June 11th at White Oak Hospital. I feel like there's probably some names that I should have tried to remember from that ledger. The balcony.
There's got to be a way through.
Okay.
Look at this wallpaper.
Mmm.
This is old as hell.
Everything here is old as hell.
Which is
wild. I was expecting
wild.
An old exterior, but
yeah.
Remodeled inside.
Right? Because everything's supposed to be new on the inside? Tape player.
Manny Sherman, born January 1, 1956.
Okay.
Come on. You know all this. What do you want? What's this? Huh. You've been doing your research.
Monday.
Special Agent Monday. What are my favorite television programs? Describe my first pet? What were your friends like as a child? What is this? You're taking a survey, you're trying to learn something. Would it kill you to be direct? You wanted to know what inspired me? As if I wasn't an original? Well, maybe there was
H.
one man I found myself a little fascinated by. Henry Howard Holmes. Why? Because he was numero uno. America's first. The guy invented the trade. He set the benchmark, you know? Learn your history, Monday. Read a book. You think because I stuck a blade in some people and get off on it, I'm not smart? I allegedly killed 13 people before you got smart enough to find me.
What looks like Dumet is trying to preserve things.
Can't be easy all the way out here.
Yeah.
I like antiques as much as the next person, but at some point you have to give up the ghost.
Give up the ghost. Do we take a look?
Rod is gonna set in.
There. See that key?
Yep.
Just need to find a way through.
We're going upstairs. Okay. Ladder.
Old house.
Yeah.
Island beaches with dead fish, animals in the wood. Could be anything.
Whatever it is, it's dead as hell.
I feel like it probably stinks in here too. Nope. All right, jump. What a thing to do in someone else's house. Let me just knock this down. Okay. Okay, now we're cooking.
Go. Put your head down.
Sir, I think she'll be okay. No. See, it's stuff like that. It's stuff like that where you're being watched on the security cameras. I don't like that. Oh, this is stressing me out. Okay. Turn that off. I can't jump across that, right? But if I can, that's just bookshelves. Can we move this guy? Yeah. Nice. There's just a lot of hard labor going into this. I'm here to film and take pictures. But I also really don't understand why he let everybody think that she broke up with him. That's a weird one, right? Jump and jump. And then, Kate, if you wouldn't mind putting that back so I could jump over there. Oh, you're not in here. You didn't feel the need to follow me.
Mark?
Got it.
You okay in there?
I'll be right back.
Yeah, I'm fine. You could have definitely followed me. I see how it is. Just make me do all the tedious stuff. Mm-hmm. Also, the strength on this man. It's like fairly easy. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What do we got? What do we got? Examine. Nothing. Okay. Let's get this key. Get the key, we open the door, we shoot this intro. Also, they were going to dinner. Maybe this is happening at the same time. That's what it is. Everybody's breathing way too hard. Okay.
You can do this.
Get the key. We'll be good to go. Mm-hmm. Check these books. Nothing. Check here. Nothing. Okay. Just the key. Take it. What's it say? Balcony. Perfect. We go open the balcony. We're good. It's like, please let me just go through this door. I have to go, I have to do all that again to get back. And where was the balcony? It was in here, right? Yeah, there we go. Something's gonna pop out at me. No. Okay.
Whoa.
Just come on. It's not that high.
My vertigo is saying otherwise.
You're inside the house. Just don't go for the rail.
What are you worried about, Miss Always Be Camera Ready? You look amazing as usual.
I gotta get them, back together. But this doesn't belong to the victims of H.H. Holmes. He had a lot of victims.
Kate, check this out.
His hat.
Who?
H.H. Holmes.
Don't touch it. Do not.
You okay?
No! I just... This thing popped out of nowhere.
Didn't get me. Okay. Fine.
See?
What is it? Some kind of animatronic?
Yeah, a looking one.
It can't hurt you.
It scared you.
It scared you twice.
Okay.
Hey, Charlie, it's 8. Dinner time.
We didn't get anything.
There's still time.
Come on, let's not keep Charlie waiting or we'll never hear the end of it.
They're so subservient to Charlie.
Hey, be civil with Charlie.
He's the one who chose to be uncivil blowing up on me when all I did was my job. I'm the one doing the talking on camera, not him.
Come on, you came in hot on him and you know it. Not that you're wrong, but you know he meets anger with more anger.
This is on him, Mark, not me.
Empathic.
I know Charlie can be a pain in the ass.
Did you see his notes?
Yeah, I saw them.
I can't say half the he writes. It may look good on the page, but there's more to it. I'm trying to help, and he throws it back in my face.
Because he thinks you're just trying to get content for your showreel.
What if I was?
Directors have to be? No. No, he does think that he owns us.
Charlie does seem to think he owns us. He's so damn.
Yeah, go through it together so you get closer.
Don't control me. Why else do you think we fight so much?
Did you know Aaron hasn't been paid in weeks? He told her that learning from him was its own reward.
Wow. You piece of there you go. Go through it and get closer.
Yes, come on. Running around town, picking up his laundry, doing his shopping like he can't do anything for himself. Doesn't matter. One way or another, I am moving on from Lon at Entertainment.
Saying that so loud into the middle of the house. That we'd move on together. Yeah. Supportive.
Good for you. That's definitely the right call for where your career is going.
That sounded very sincere.
Because it is.
There we go.
Charlie would replace us in a second if he wouldn't be inconveniencing himself. He's using us. I deserve better than this. So do you.
You do.
We all do.
We do.
What a stunning performance. You should give up news and be an actress.
Yeah.
I was quite moved by all that. Oscar worthy.
You don't know what we were talking about.
I heard enough, thank you. I know what betrayal sounds like. I'm particularly disappointed in you, Mark.
I don't care.
Whatever your future plans may be, right now, you work for Lonnet Entertainment, and Lonnet Entertainment employees are meeting for dinner to speak with our host.
Charlie, I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry.
And Lonnet employees are professionals, yes? So no, start acting like it.
Employees get paid, though. She an employee?
Great. Happy? You have a future, and now I don't.
That man is a child, and somehow we all sink to his level.
Still screaming. Nobody's got a whisper voice in this?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, guys.
Oh, you can't say hello?
Think it's okay if we pour some wine?
God, please do.
Has anyone seen Mr. Dumet? Shouldn't we wait for him?
Just pour, Mark.
Let's all just relax. We just sat down, give the man a moment. He's the host.
There we go.
I haven't seen a soul here aside from the groundskeeper. He's probably cooking dinner himself.
Ah, Mr. Dumet!
I love what you've done with your hair. We started on the wine. Hope that's all right with
Dumet?
You.
Dumet? Yeah, back to it ain't coming.
Wait, what? Why?
Now she tells them.
He saw all the snide things you tweeted from his limo.
I didn't.
What are you talking about, Jamie?
He got back aboard the ferry and left.
What? When?
Right after we got to our rooms.
He just left.
You didn't want to tell us anything?
You must be mistaken.
I'm not blind. I know what I saw.
Why would he leave?
That makes no sense.
Tell them he left with the little girl.
They're in a big-ass hurry. Guess you were right. There was some kid here.
I saw them together when I was looking for my room.
Another perfect Charles Lonnet plan comes together. What's our next step, boss? Swim for shore?
Why would he invite us here and to dinner and then just leave?
You know what? I don't like him, so here we go.
I'm about done with you all questioning my judgment. The man tells me he has artifacts useful to our investigation. Look around you. Did he lie?
There has to be a legit reason he left. We shouldn't leap to conclusions.
Guys, am I the only one who's getting really freaked out by this place? And by Mr. Dumet? As much as it pains me from the depths of my soul to say it, I'm trying to side with Jamie on this one.
Thank you.
Lower your voices.
Why? He's not here.
But that doesn't explain why he stitched out on us.
He had to go back to establish an alibi.
What are you?
You know, so when our bodies wash up on the other side of the lake, he has plausible deniability.
Oh, God, Jamie.
I mean, she's
trying to make this worse.
You're not helping.
Okay, fine. Just don't come crying to me if you end up dead.
What is wrong with you?
I'm just saying.
She's not wrong at all.
Guess you never found your cigarettes.
The f*** of it is, I did find a machine, but just like everything else in this f***ing place, it's ancient and broken.
So what are we doing? We just gonna sit here and pretend to eat? What's the plan, Charlie?
The plan? In true Lawn and Entertainment fashion, we're going to sit with our thumbs in our asses until a panic deadline looms over us. And then we'll just throw some together and I'll save it with a voiceover.
Well, here's to Topeka no longer being the worst decision Charlie has
made. Charlie about to lose his mind. Charlie about to lose his mind. Toast? Hostile. Turn up, Charlie.
Enough. I'd like to propose a toast. It seems as if this may well be our last supper as a team, given how you've all been acting. Me and my apostles. Just wait. Give me a moment. I can't decide who the Judas is.
Okay, Google. Stop. Okay.
I've got so many options.
And of course, you're the martyr.
You're going to find out very soon that you won't get very far without being a team player, Kate.
Enough Sunday school, Charlie. What's your problem now?
You know, you don't always have to get a word in, Jamie. You do your best work when you're silent. Trust me.
Come on, Charlie. You want us to rally behind you. Stop treating us like crap.
Oh, turn up, Charlie.
Are you kidding me? You were the best damn DP I've ever worked with until Kate got into your head and made you insecure and neurotic.
That's not...
You think you're too good for this, don't you? You think you're an artist? Fine. Go take some pretty pictures and see if that pays the bills.
Oh. He's gonna yell at old girl too? When he doesn't paid?
You can blame my mood on Erin.
Blame it on Erin?
She lost my smoke.
You're a grown-ass man. Bring your own cigarettes. And why are you smoking cigarettes?
Cheers, everyone.
She didn't screw up. She may seem all doe-eyed and lost, but she knows exactly what she's doing.
Oh.
Then where are they, Jamie?
Did you check up your ass?
Got him.
Oh.
Charlie, you're the director. You're not God. You're not the king. We're not your royal subjects that must kiss your ass and cater to your whims. Okay. No, he needs to hear this. Mm-hmm. He doesn't give a single about our feelings, our careers, our needs.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that one hurt her. That one hurt.
This is just priceless.
I can't believe you said that to me. This.
Enjoying watching Charlie lose all control of his precious plan? Yeah, maybe a little.
Enough, Jamie.
Dude, you've lost the right to tell us what to do. Look at where we are.
Is that what you all think?
Mm-hmm.
You're all in agreement about this?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Unbelievable.
Turn up.
What do we do? We're like alone here. We don't have our phones.
Dumb choices.
It's not like we can leave until he's back. May as well keep busy.
Okay. Yeah, I'm done. I'd rather be staring at a blank wall than sit here any longer.
Can I come with you? You're putting your headphones on? That's a terrible idea.
Hey, Mark. You want to follow Kate around like a lost dog, or should we start planning what gear to pull?
There's good light in the lobby. Minimal setup time. We can be good to go in 15.
Then let's do it.
At the very least, your sets are the most entertaining I've ever been on.
You've always got something to say, haven't
yeah.
you?
Everybody turn
yes.
up.
It's my superpower.
Get him, Jamie. Look at these relationships. Look at these relationships. They're all in the garbage. Who else? Aaron? Jamie in the gutter. Kate in the gutter. Mark in the gutter. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Yeah. Yeah, you should have been nicer.
Mark is right. Light in there is good. Just need to set up a couple fills. Won't take long.
Grand.
Now you're just breaking stuff? You don't... I don't understand him. If he turns them into mannequins, he's already done it. He's setting up the scene. And he's put his hat on him, because it suits him, doesn't it? And his cigarettes. I bet you he's got his cigarettes, too. Oh, inhaler time. Pick it up. Okay. There we go. So we only have 3 more hits of that? Kind of terrifying. No.
Hello? Guys? Is that you?
Why are you putting your headphones on? Okay, smart. Actually very smart.
Thank you.
Okay, the book. Yep. Just make sure it's the same thing. Okay. Oh, yes. Breathing techniques for emergencies. Let's go. In earlier chapters, we looked at how abdominal breathing can help build resilience against anxiety. Practicing techniques such as Tummo or Pranayama for just 20 minutes a day has been shown to build a buffer against stress over time. But sometimes when sudden anxiety panic attacks set in, you need quicker techniques for the moment. This is what we'll be explaining in this chapter. The 5 for 5. Find a seat that's as comfortable as possible and loosen any restrictive clothing. Breathe in gently through your nose for 5 seconds. Try not to breathe into your stomach. Try to breathe into your stomach, but don't worry if you can't. Breathe out through your mouth for 5 seconds as if you're blowing out a candle. Repeat this for 5 minutes until you begin to feel calmer. Note, some people find it helpful to picture a relaxing environment whilst they breathe. I like to imagine floating through space, discovering new planets while far away from Earth. What might your relaxing environment be? Okay. In and out. Breathe in and out.
Or just put your headphones on.
Okay, but maybe that gives us an extra inhaler hit. Oh, premonition. Show me something. Lungs. So, she's getting stabbed in the face. So, okay, so make sure that I don't get stabbed in the face. Well, technically in the chin, I guess.
Sure, they fill my pine box with cement, put me deeper than anyone else. Cover the ground with more cement, cause trust me. Just being dead ain't enough to stop me from killing again.
Mm-mm. Okay. Gotta find. That's what we just saw, right? Yeah, it's the lungs. Okay. Let's go back. Okay. We're going. Also, what is the aversion to knocking on someone's door and being like, hey, I'm hearing weird noises. Are you? Come on, dude. He's crying. What's happening in there? This is when you take your ass back to your room, people are just screaming. Stabbed. Jeez, this is terrifying. All of the furniture is destroyed downstairs. What? What? Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. Is he gonna stay alive though?